Welcome back again students in the class of 5th science, and today you are going to collect the knowledge about our chapter number 3, that is rocks and minerals. Dear students, we find rocks everywhere on the earth, and our earth itself is made up of rocks. These rocks are made up of tiny grains that are called as minerals. So we find minerals in the soil also. We find many different types of rocks in our surrounding. And their colors are also different, as well as size also. The color of rocks are different because they are made up of different minerals. Suppose if the rock is made up of only one type of a mineral, then the rock is of a single color. And suppose if multicolor rock, if you see, and that are made up of, then different minerals are present in that rock. So let's see the different types of rocks classified on the basis of their formation. Rocks can be classified into three groups: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. They differ in the method of their formation, their degree of hardness, texture, color, and in their chemical composition. Igneous rocks were the first rock to form on the earth, so also they are called as a primary rock. They were the basis of most landforms such as plains, mountains, and ocean beds. These rocks are formed by the solidification of the hot molten material called as magma. Our earth is made up of three layers: the outermost crust, middle layer mantle, and the innermost is core. Core is the hottest part of the earth, as it is made up of melted rocks. This molten mass of melted rocks and metals is called as magma. The magma is sometimes pushed upwards by the intense pressure of other rocks inside the earth, and it gushes out to the very weak spots of the mountains, causing a volcanic eruption. The magma that reaches the earth's surface is known as lava, which then cools down and forms igneous rocks. Dear students, do the practice of drawing this diagram, as it is related with formation of igneous rocks. Igneous rocks have fine texture. They are dense and dark in color. They contain minerals such as mica, feldspar, and quartz. They also contain silica, iron, and magnesium. Igneous rocks are of different types. Let's see one by one. Granite, pumice, basalt, and obsidian are some examples of the igneous rocks. Granite is a hard rock with coarse grains. It comes in many colors and patterns. As the granite comes in contact with the atmospheric condition, this is the most common igneous rock found on the earth. It is used to make buildings, floors, and statues. Obsidian, it is a black, smooth, and glassy rock formed by the quick cooling of lava. Obsidian is used in making cutting tools because of its sharp edges. It is also used in making surgical instruments. This rock is pumice, and it is formed by lava cooling on the earth's surface. Its peculiarity is that it is made from frothy lava containing a lot of dissolved gases. When this lava cools, it forms the rock with several holes and pockets inside it because of the gas. Pumice is used as a scrubber to remove rough skin from the body. It is also used by the dentist in powdered form to polish the teeth. This rock is brittle as well. It is also light enough to float on water. Basalt rock is very dark and dense in color, as the minerals present in it are iron and magnesium. Also, it is very hardest rock, so it is mainly used for the construction of roads. On the basis of formation, the second type is sedimentary rocks. Now, sedimentary rocks means that is formed by the sediments. What are these sediments? Let's see: water, wind, that carry away the pieces of rocks, mud, pebbles, gravel, and sand, and they get deposited. This leads to the formation of a layer, and such deposits are called as sediments. As more and more layers settle on the top, they get squeezed together, and minerals deposit on them and cement them together to form a solid rock. Such rocks are known as sedimentary rocks. When these rocks are formed in the river, lakes and seas, with the flow of water, it also carries small animals and plants along with it. And these get buried with the other sediments. And they form fossils. The examples of sedimentary rocks are shale, limestone, sandstone, dolomite and conglomerate, etc. Conglomerate is a solid mass of pebbles and they are cemented together by the minerals. Conglomerate is used to polish the ornaments and also as a decorative rock. It is mostly grey or orange in color. Shale is a sedimentary rock made up of clay under heavy pressure that hardens the rock. And it is also used to make brick and tiles. Sandstone is formed with this very fine particles of sand that get cemented together by other minerals. Sand consists of a mineral called quartz. Sandstones may be red, pink, brown or yellow in color. They are used as a building material. The famous monuments such as Red Fort and Qutub Minar are made up of red sandstone. This limestone is a fine-grained, soft rock. It is made up of largely of a mineral called calcite. This mineral is present in shells and skeleton of sea animals which gets squeezed into the sediments and it is formed. The chalk we use in classroom is one of the example of limestone. Glass, cement and paint are also made from limestone. The third type of rock on the basis of the formation is metamorphic rocks. These rocks are formed by the process of metamorphosis. This means the change in form. These rocks are formed from igneous rocks or sedimentary rocks which undergoes the different heat and pressure and bring the changes in their structure and composition. Some examples of metamorphic rocks are slate, marble, gneiss and quartzite. Slate is a metamorphosis of shale, marble of limestone, gneiss is metamorphosis of granite, quartzite it is a metamorphosis of sandstone. Slate is formed from sedimentary rock shale. It is very fine grain and soft, so it splits into thin sheets very easily. It is mainly black or grey in color. It is useful for making roofing material, pavements and also blackboards. Marble is formed from limestone and it is usually white in color. Only when it has a mineral purity means only one type of a mineral. Marble is used for making statues and buildings. The Taj Mahal is a fine example of a building made up of white marble. Gneiss is made from igneous rock, granite. It is a rock with a coarse texture. It has many minerals in it, so it appears like bands all over the surface. Gneiss often glitters due to the presence of mica. It is also used in making statues. Quartzite is formed from sandstone that is rich in quartz mineral. Hence, the name is quartzite. It is very hard and used in glass and cement industries. The next point of the chapter is coal, an important sedimentary rock. Coal is a naturally occurring fuel in the environment. Now let's see how the coal is formed in our environment. The coal is formed from the dead plants and trees in the surrounding. These forests were grown in the marshy places. The dead plants and the trees get buried in the soil. And so it goes on and forming a layer of dead trees. It gets squeezed and due to heat and pressure, it converts into the coal. It takes millions of years for the formation of coal. The uses of coal are, it is used for cooking food, making dyes and colors. It is used in medicines to kill the germs. Natural purifier agent, it is used in railway steam engines and thermal power stations to generate electricity. The next point of the chapter is petroleum and another important fuel like coal. The word petroleum is derived from Latin word petra means rock and oleum means oil. It is a mineral oil found in the rocks. Petroleum is formed from the dead remains of sea animals that were buried under the soil millions of years ago. And by the action of heat and pressure, it changes into petroleum. The petroleum we get by digging special wells into the oil-bearing rocks. Petroleum is also known as crude oil, rock oil, fossil fuel. The petroleum cannot be used in its natural states, so it is then refined and then turned into the various types of fuel such as petrol, diesel, LPG and kerosene. Uses of petroleum are, it is used as a fuel in vehicles, dry cleaning of clothes, making paints, cosmetics, fertilizers, lubricating oils, candles from wax, etc. LPG form of petroleum is used in cooking. Coal and petroleum are both stored form of energy of the sun from millions of years ago. So it is the important fuel of today. Coal and petroleum are the valuable underground natural resources, and also they are very limited as they are formed from the plants and animals. So we must use them limitedly and also conserve them. Dear students, find out some solution for this problem so we can conserve the natural resource. Or how can we make the use of less coal and petroleum? Burning of a fuel adds lot of harmful substances in the environment and it makes the pollution. Pollution causes various diseases also. So it is one of the reason that we should use less and less coal and petroleum. So students, why don't we make use of more and more solar energy? Yes, we can use more and more solar energy to stop pollution also and make our environment free of pollution. The energy of the sun is never ending and it will be never finished. And we can get this energy in plenty. Solar cells are the special cells which traps the sunlight and convert it into the electricity. We can also make the use of solar cookers, solar water heaters, etc. The other unending source of energy are wind and water, flowing water. In future, we have to make the use of these unending source of energy more and more. The other underground resources that we find in the earth are metals, that are example copper, aluminium, gold, silver, etc. These are called as ores. We also find some precious stone inside the earth that are diamond and rubies, sapphires, etc. So students, this was all about the topic rocks and minerals. Hope you understand the chapter. And as the subject science is a subject of exploring, so keep go on exploring and keep on learning. Thank you.